My name is Hitoshi Tanaka. I received my bachelor's degree in 63, master's degree in 65, and doctorate degree in 76. I'm currently senior vice president of Designtronics, and unfortunately I didn't stay in academia, but I went into industry.
And why unfortunate?
Well, you know, some people think that I received a doctorate degree and didn't really go into the field where that degree is utilized. But I felt that the education was very important to me, that it did help in my career.
And so you went back to back through Columbia? This is all Columbia degrees?
Yes, they're all from Mechanical Engineering Department at Columbia. The reason that I have such a gap between my master's degree and doctorate degree was that I was working full-time after master's degree, and I was going to going toward my doctorate degree part-time. And now, my thesis advisor was Professor Feldman Freudenstein, and I'm one of his doctoral students.
See. So, are you guys contemporaries then?
Yes, 76 is my doctorate degree. So I know him, Nejat Ogach. What happened was that I have, of course, being here for such a long time, I developed very intimate relationship with people in the mechanical engineering department. And it has been my second home. And I like to really show my appreciation to Columbia by participating in various activities. Now, the way I got current job, which goes back to 75 actually, was facilitated by my professor. And he introduced me to one of his earlier doctoral students by the name of Frank Buxbaum. And he was an executive at Designtronics at that time. And that's how I became part of Designtronics. And I've been there for 37 years. And Columbia Education not only taught me all the things I needed to learn academically, but in many other ways, and especially Professor Freudenstein's influence in my development was very important.
Tell us a little bit about Professor Freudenstein. How would you characterize him as a person?
Well, what was really amazing thing about him was that...
Would you start again, say his name?
Okay. What was really amazing thing about Professor Freudenstein was he was such a humble person. And even though he was such a brilliant man, you would not know it if you were just sitting next to him in the subway. And he was always very thoughtful, very caring of his students. And the fact that he introduced me to this Dr. Frank Buxbaum and made sure that I was doing well by inquiring from time to time. We had contacts. I think that just shows how caring he was.
And can you just let us know why he was so famous?
He is known as the father of the modern kinematics. And by the way, I was working for a Singer company prior to joining Designtronics, where I was involved in mechanism design and analysis. And it was natural for me to ask Professor Freudenstein to be my thesis advisor.
Okay, so How many years did it take you to get your PhD then?
Actually, it took me 11 years.
Say the whole thing, please. It
took me 11 years to get my doctorate degree after my master's. Wow. And all that time, I was coming to Colombia.
So you must have seen a lot of things happen here, right?
Yes.
All those years. You have family, too, I presume. You probably...
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so you don't need to go about that. What does Design Atronics, obviously it's now 30 years hence, but when
yes.
you first got there, what was the feature of that company? What were you
well, it was much smaller.
Design
Atronics, when I joined, was a much smaller company. And I think at the time, we had one building which was about two-thirds occupied by Design Atronics. Now we have four buildings, we have several divisions, primarily in manufacturing and distributing mechanical components. So we do have, even though we are located in Long Island, we do have factory there. We have about 320 employees, and we are actually making parts to sell to various industries.
For example, what kind of industries?
Well, we have aerospace customers, medical equipment, defense, several, all kinds of manufacturing companies use us as a supplier of components.
So do you actually design them for them as well? Or you
sometimes, yes, we do custom design. Others are what we consider standard catalog items. We have very thick catalogs. And one of the things we do is we donate parts to senior design projects that mechanical engineering students do in their senior year. So every year we supply parts, and I'm happy to be part of a judge in the competition at the end of the semester.
That's very nice. So those wonderful things too. Have you gone down there yet today and seen?
No, not this semester yet.
Okay, so in a couple of days we're going to see that.
Right, okay. next week.
Wait till you see the muffin maker. That's all I have to say.
Okay.
And I was like, wow, who did this? It's really something. No. Very, very, very smart girl.
One of the things I want to tell tell you about is that now I'm very heavily involved with Columbia Engineering Alumni Association. So I've been a board member for a while, and this year I'm vice president in charge of faculty relations, and I'm president-elect for the next year. And I think it's very important for alumni to participate in these activities to support the engineering school.
Okay, that's great. So you're going to be the president of the Alumni Association, huh? Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, that's good. Everything bodes very well now, I think, here at Columbia and the engineering school. We have a new dean coming in.
Yes.
Have you met her now?
Yes.
Okay, well, I'm not going to ask you what you think about her. I don't know myself. I'm not on camera. Okay. But, what's it? Well, I mean, this is a question we do ask. In your case, I mean, this may not be pertinent, but if you were to have to do this all over again, would you have done anything different?
If I have to do it all over again, I think I would have tried to do my doctorate degree a little faster. It was good in one way that it took so long, because I was attending school for such a long time that the learning became part of my life. So it was not all negative, but it was a long haul. So 11 years is a little too long.
Well, I mean, as a PhD candidate, you wanted to be on the cutting edge of research, I presume. In 11 years, things may have been evolving quite a bit underneath you while you were...
Well, I was, at the beginning, I was only taking courses, just getting enough credits, and then last really 2 years is when I did my research.
What was that research in?
It was on in kinematics, in mechanisms design.
And any other memory or recollection or people or things you told us about that might interest people today?
Well, you know, one of the interesting thing I work in this alumni association, and two of the active members, former presidents, one is Guy Longobardo, who was a professor, and actually I took his courses. So that's very interesting. And his wife, Anna Longobardo, they are both very active in many activities of Columbia University. So it's great to see them every time we have a fair here.
Okay, we almost interviewed Anna, but she's going to be interviewed by a serious documentarian who's going to really press her for details.
I see.
I'm like, oh, I'm not going to do this, so okay, it's fine, but I think this is great. Okay, so how many kids do you have now?
I have two kids, one boy and one girl. I have to say they're all grown up, so. Sure.
Have they gone to Columbia themselves?
No, they did not. They had their own minds. You know, as a parent, you cannot dictate anything to kids anymore.
I don't know if you ever could. I have a 19-year-old, so I know. Anyways, okay, so let me think. Anything else you'd like to add to this, picture-wise?
No, I think...
So you traveled in from Long Island? Where did you live?
I live in New Jersey. Mm-hmm. And now I work in Long Island. I commute long distance every day.
Any reflection on the evolution of the mechanical engineering field yourself? Anything you'd like to say?
Well, you know, not being in academics, I'm not, you know, the only really development I see is every time I come to Columbia, I talk to many professors and I have contact, kept up the contact. And so I hear all the new developments going on. The research is being done. It's just fantastic. It's just cutting edge research being done by faculty. And I'm very proud of how the Columbia Engineering School and specifically Mechanical Engineering Department has come along.
That's a nice thing. Okay, good. So if you could once again just introduce yourself at the beginning and give us an idea of what you do in the world now.
My name is Hitoshi Tanaka. I am Senior Vice President of Design Electronics currently. And this is a company that produces primarily mechanical drive components. We have six divisions and two subsidiaries. And they are all primarily engaged in manufacture and the distribution of various types of mechanical components.
And now if you could just say, I got my undergraduate degree in this year, a master's degree in this year, and finally I got my PhD in this year, all from Columbia University Engineering.
And I received my bachelor's degree in 1963. By the way, today this year is our 50th reunion year, and I'm very excited about the reunion weekend coming up. I'm a co-chair of the reunion committee. And we have, believe it or not, I think a record number of alumni coming from my class this year. And I obtained my master's degree in 65 and a Doctor of Engineering Science degree in 76, all from Mechanical Engineering Department of Columbia University.
Good. So let me ask you another question. In 1963, was there an engineering school? I mean, I know that Columbia College Engineering School was somehow...
I started my undergraduate in 1959, and that was the first year of the four-year engineering program. Prior to that, it was a five-year program, and I probably could not have come to Columbia if they didn't have a four-year program because my parents wouldn't have been able to afford me to go to school for 5 years.
And why did you come to Columbia back then?
Well, I was living in Manhattan, and I was attending Bronx High School of Science. And my parents could not send me to school outside of the city. Actually, I was one of those commuting students. We lived on Riverside Drive, and it was one subway stop away from Columbia. So aside from Columbia being the best school in the area, it was also convenient for me.
Good. That's an interesting story. Okay, so anything else you want to say to us now while I got you here? Good. Well, I look forward to seeing you on reunion weekend.
Okay, very good.
Let me get that microphone as you stand up. And we'll